Hey everybody, welcome to the channel.
Hey guys, we're your hosts, Em and Jay.
And today we want to take another look at She-Ra and the Princesses of Power. This time we're analyzing Angela, the Queen of Brightmoon, Glimmer's mother and the original leader of the Great Rebellion. She's a very complex character. She has a nurturing personality which clashes with her having to lead the rebellion against the invading horde, and it's definitely taken a toll on her. Despite this, she's still very determined to end the war and free the planet from the oppressive regime. She often clashes with Glimmer. Oftentimes, Glimmer wants to face the Horde head-on and take a lot more risks in the war, while Angela is much more strategic and cautious in her planning. Glimmer's concerned that they aren't making progress fast enough, which is understandable, but she has a bad habit of not thinking things through, and it gets to the point of her being reckless and she ends up causing problems for the Rebellion. I think it would have been a great opportunity for them to come together. If they could have met in the middle, they could have been a real force against the Horde. Since Angela had become too defensive in her approach to the war, while Glimmer was too reckless, it would have been great for their character development and fleshing out their relationship. Unfortunately, that's not really what happens.
We don't get much backstory for Angela. In fact, we probably get more backstory for Micah, probably because they gave him Cassa's Fella story, which gave him a connection to Shadow Weaver. So everything we know about her is in relation to the war and the rebellion, and unfortunately none of that went well. Angela ordered an attack which seemingly got her husband killed. Emphasis on seemingly. This event had a huge impact on Angela because she blames herself and is plagued with guilt. Soon the Princess Alliance fell apart, with everyone choosing to go off on their own and protect their own kingdoms rather than try to work together. And all that happened under Angela's watch, which would make her responsible. This causes her to be a lot more cautious in her leadership, probably because she doesn't want to end up with a repeat of what happened to Micah. But as a result, things aren't progressing in the war, and it also causes her to be very protective of Glimmer, since she's her only family left, which causes Glimmer to try to prove herself, but she ends up going too far. There's one point where they locate a piece of First One's tech, but it's in the Crimson Waste, which is believed to be one of the most dangerous and inhospitable places in all of Etheria. Queen Angela and also Bo's parents decided that it was too dangerous to risk going out there to retrieve the technology. This dilemma could have been a good opportunity for them all to work together to try to find an effective way to reduce the risk but still accomplish their goals. But instead, Glimmer decides to rush off into the Crimson Waste without telling the Princess Alliance what they're doing, despite the fact that they spent an entire season trying to get them together. So the Princess Alliance is totally in the dark about where their commander is and where She-Ra is, and the Best Friend Squad didn't even have a plan for what they were doing. They didn't even bring supplies with them and had no way of contacting the Alliance in case something went wrong. Not that the Alliance would have been prepared, but they could have tried at least. But they end up getting ambushed by Catra, Scorpia, and some bandits from the Crimson Waste. They're forced to retreat, but in the process, Adora gets captured. So now Adora and the Sword of Protection have fallen to the Horde's hands. Then when they do get back, they don't really explain themselves. They say that Adora has been captured and they have to go rescue her, but this information completely catches the Queen and the rest of the Alliance off guard, which is understandable since they have no idea what's going on. Angela tries to talk to Glimmer and explain that they need a plan, and to figure things out before they start rushing in, since that can cause serious problems, which we just saw happen with Adora getting kidnapped. But Glimmer still insists on rushing headfirst directly into the heart of enemy territory. I can't really fault Angela for chastising her for being so reckless. All she really wants is to make a plan, instead of blindly charging into the Fright Zone. But instead of taking a step back and reflecting on the mistake she made, Glimmer just points the finger at Angela, calling her a coward for not being willing to do anything. But she isn't saying not to do anything. She's just saying they need to be strategic about their moves. Now they're wasting all this time arguing while Adora is still being held in the Fright Zone, when they could be coming up with a plan to try to remedy the situation. Glimmer also tries to justify her actions by saying it's okay for her to go behind the Alliance's back, because Queen Angela didn't tell her that Shadow Weaver was Micah's old teacher. But I don't think that argument really holds water. Shadow Weaver trained Micah in his youth. That was way before he was with Angela. It's just not that relevant to Angela herself. The way the scene is framed seems to imply we're supposed to be back in Glimmer, because Angela is framed in Shadow, but Glimmer's just not being reasonable here, and her arguments don't hold up. Glimmer's accusations aren't really fair either. Angela is a single mother who's doing her best to try to raise her daughter, while also trying to rule a nation and hold off alien invaders. That's a lot of stress to be under. I think calling her a coward is really dismissive, especially when you add on the fact that she's been punishing herself with guilt over the loss of Micah. She and Glimmer both have targets on their back because of this situation with the war, and Angela is desperately trying to keep them safe. I don't blame Glimmer for feeling smothered, but there were much better ways to communicate and much better actions to take than just running off into the desert and calling her mom a coward. If she wants Angela to take more risks, shaming her and going behind her back is not the way to do it. But that's exactly what she does, and then she blames Angela when things go south. And this ends up being the last conversation they ever have. Glimmer goes behind her mother's back again to free Shadow Weaver, so they can attempt a rescue mission of Adora and the sword. To the surprise of no one, it goes bad, because Shadow Weaver isn't as good as she says she is and ends up not being able to teleport them into the right chamber. So by the time they do get to where they need to be, Catra activates a very unstable machine that causes the world to end. Great job, guys. So now the only way to save the world is for somebody to make a sacrifice and be trapped between dimensions, and Angela is the one who ends up making the sacrifice, so that Adora doesn't have to. She also says that she is a coward, and this sacrifice will set that right. This ends up coming off like she internalized what Glimmer said to her, because it's really not fair to her character. It totally dismisses all the weight this woman has had to carry. She's absent for the rest of the series after this because this is treated like a death, even though I think they probably could get her back if they tried to, but I digress. But I think this is a shame because there was more they could do with her character. I feel like in the end, Angela came to understand Glimmer's perspective, but the same can't be said for Glimmer, even though I personally think that would have benefited her character. There can definitely be a lot of drama when killing off a character, but it can also be kind of disappointing if said character had more potential in the story, and we personally feel like Angela never got the credit that she deserved. But that's our opinion. What do you guys think? We'd love to hear from you, so leave a comment down below. Before we go, we want to give a shout out to our members: Caleb Nelson, Stutania, Tyrant Carnivore, Adam K, Shiny Orc Boy, Taylor Ramirez, The Rabbit Mancer, Dash Hound, Haley Kosheva, Ray Thulu, Hunter Rose, General Bolivar, Depth Charge Media, Samaru163, and Kopitio Bozinski. Thank you so much for your support. We also have Buy Me Coffee if you want to support us that way. If you enjoyed this video, you can leave a like and subscribe to the channel to see more content like this. That helps us out a lot too. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you all in the next video. Bye everyone. Bye guys.